Good morning, students of class 8. Now today I will discuss on the next portion of the chapter, that is synthetic fiber and plastics. Now in the previous classes I have discussed on what is synthetic fiber and already started the one with an example, that is the rayon. It is a synthetic fiber. We know that it is obtained from the plant extract or the fibers which is obtained from the plant. Now there is a difference between the synthetic rayon and also the silk. I have made these questions in the previous class. Now for the important questions from the previous section is, what is rayon and what is the difference between rayon and the natural fiber, rayon and the silk, and also some example and why rayon becomes so popular, what is the uses of rayon. These are the important areas from the previous class. Now today's class over the nylon, that is the next discussion on the nylon. Now what is nylon? Now nylon is the general term which is used in our daily life. Now there are different kinds of nylon, but here it is the first form synthetic fiber. Here it is the first form synthetic fiber. And it is discovered in the year 1931, and the first discovered nylon was nylon 66. First discovered nylon was nylon 66. This is the this is an idea, the 1931. Now there is no any fiber is used. Just like the in comparison to rayon, we have used the plant fibers, but here no fibers is used. It is totally chemically made. What is the composition used to make this? That is cold water and air. Cold water and air. These are the three components. Cold water and air. These are the three components from which we can produce the nylon. Right. Now next, it is the fully synthetic fiber. First, it is the first form, it is the first form or first discovered synthetic fiber. Right. Now what is the definition of this? You may write it down. Nylon is a made up of repeating units of amide. Nylon is made up of repeating units of amide of a chemical called amide. So nylon is polyamide. Nylon is polyamide. Right. So this is the nylon. Now what is the advantage of using nylon? Now we know that for this purpose, that is our daily needs, contain the toothbrush etc. and the socks etc. and the clothes, which also comes from the nylon fibers. Now these are the this comes with very lightweight and also having high tensile strength and also lustrous and less affinity towards water. So what are the properties? That is lightweight. Second one, that is lustrous and comes less affinity towards water and also soft. So these are the basic characteristics of nylon fiber. Now for this reason there are uses in the varieties of field, that is in the production of the toothbrushes and also in the production of wrinkle free articles, that is wrinkle free clocks etc., ropes, tents etc., and car belt, sleeping bag curtain are also made by nylon. There are the parachutes and climbing rope. That is a rope uses to for rock climbing. Now these are also comes from the nylon fiber. Why? Because in place of steel wire, there is the newly it is the uses of iron wire. Is the nylon wire. Where? Why? Because of lightweight, light easy to carry. Easy to carry, number one, high tensile strength. High tensile strength. So these are the basic properties which is different from the steel wire. Steel wire having less tensile strength than that of the iron, than that of the nylon. So it is about nylon. So first it is first fully synthetic. First form fully synthetic fiber. Next one, it is the basic properties of this: lightweight, ductile, less affinity towards water, and high tensile strength. And the uses, that is the different uses of nylon fiber. Next one, it is also made to it is also used to make the yarn also. Now why nylon rope is used to to climb the rock, I have already discussed. This is the two reason for which the nylon rope is used to climb in the rock. Now next one example, that is nylon 66 and also nylon 6. Nylon 66, nylon 6 is also an example of nylon. So this is nylon. Next one, what is polyester? Okay, before going to that, I have to discover what is amine or polyamine. Polyamine. So nylon is made up of polyamide ring or polyamide. Now what is polyamide? Now amide is a chemical compound. Amide is a chemical compound when this is joined by using a linkage and form a large molecular mass, that is known as nylon. So it is a synthetic fiber which is made by an amide linkage, right? Next one is polyester. Polyester. It is also a synthetic fiber. Now here the chemical composition or the chemical compound is ester. What is ester? It is also a chemical compound, and the flavor coming out from the fruits or ripe fruit etc. is due to the presence of an ester. Now polyester is also a synthetic fiber, and it is produced from the different materials. Now esters are of organic chemicals, substances which give fruits to their sweet smell. So ester is responsible for the fruits to give sweet smell. So you have to define polyester. So what is polyester? Polyester is a synthetic fiber which is produced from the ester repeating units or repeating units of ester. What is ester? Ester is a chemical compound which is responsible for the food to smell. Now next one is the pterylene. Pterylene is a is an example of polyester. It is also a synthetic fiber, and it is comes in the category of polyester. There are different types of esters, you know, that is polycot and polyul. Polycot and polyul. So what is polycot and what is polyul? Here with the polymeric chain, the cotton fiber is also there, and in the polyul there the wool fiber is there. So when a synthetic fiber is produced by some polymer units, that is polyester with cotton and also polyester with wool, then they comes with the name, that is polycot or polyul. That is so polycot we may write polyester plus cotton, and polyul we may write polyester plus wool. So this is the two different types of yarn, you may say, or fabric, you may say, that is polycot and polyul, and this is the chemical composition, that is polyester, that is polyester plus cotton and polyester plus wool. Next one, example of polyester is the terephthalene. Terephthalene, the chemical compound used in making polyester fiber, are made from petroleum products called petrochemicals. So the next term, that is petrochemicals. What is petrochemicals? It is a very important term. Now petrochemicals, that is obtained from the petroleum. Now petroleum, we know the Vaseline petroleum jelly. Now when it is a byproduct, it is a byproduct and having the different volatility, having the different volatility, when we extracting the different compounds from the fractional distillation of the crude oil or crude petroleum, then at different temperature we get different products, and at the different products we should use in the different field. Now petrochemicals is a kind of this pattern, kind of this compound, that is when by the fractional distillation of the crude petroleum oil we get such products which is further used for making such synthetic fibers. Now in this fiber, when petroleum or petrochemicals are used to make a synthetic fiber, just like terephthalene, it is called petroleum, petrochemicals. It is also a thermoplastic. What is thermoplastic and thermosetting? We have already the knowledge that thermoplastic, which cannot, which can be molded further, and thermosetting, which cannot be molded further. Now the all the polyesters or nylon, these under the thermoplastics, that is it can be molded further, by that by heating it, it can be melted and further it can be converted to any desired shape. So the important areas here are, what is nylon, what is the advantage of nylon, and what is the uses of nylon. There is a vast use of nylon. Next one, why we should use the nylon fiber or nylon rope in place of steel rope for rock climbing. Some examples of nylon. Next one, what is polyester? Now polyester is a synthetic fiber, an example of polyester. And what is ester and petrochemicals? These are the new terms, esters and petrochemicals. And another one in the nylon, it was amide. So these are also a chemical compound. Now what is acrylic? So acrylic is also a type of synthetic fiber, and in we use acrylic in place of wool. So it has a similarity with wool, that is acrylic, it is a man-made fiber. Acrylic, that is synthetic and having similarity with wool. So the clothes or etc., or the winter dresses we use, which is made basically from the wool, are from the acrylic. Now acrylic, it is the uses, why the uses of acrylic is more, because of cheaper than that of the original one. And for this reason, the uses of such kind of synthetic fiber is increasing day by day. So here is an important part of this chapter, that is nylon, polyester and acrylic. On the next day, I will discuss on the next part and also the important questions from this chapter. So till then, goodbye. Thank you.